Hello and welcome to a very special French Grand Prix weekend here at the legendary and iconic Le Mans circuit. June 1949 was the very first Grand Prix in history. Fast forward 74 years and here we are at this magnificent circuit celebrating the 1000th Grand Prix. Where has the time gone? Now then, it's a very special occasion which calls for a very special guest. And I'm delighted to say, joining me, we just mentioned the words legendary and iconic. He is the undisputed one and only voice of MotoGP, the legend, now the MotoGP guru as well, Sir Nick Harris. Harry, great to see you. Welcome
Thank
to
you,
this
Bertie.
Special French Grand Prix. You're looking fit and well and delighted to be here, I'm sure.
Oh, fantastic. I haven't been to a Grand Prix 5.5 years and it's brought every memory you can imagine back to me and absolutely brilliant.
And yeah. We're joined here by another legend, Mr. Hervé Poncharal.
I just want to say hello. Proud to have you here.
How many races?
And a legend. And another legend.
I suppose we can ask these two guys, what was it like to be at the first Grand Prix in 1949, Hervé? a joke. We know that this guy's been to many, many Grand Prix. He's seen and done it all, hasn't he, down the years. Nick, this very, very special occasion. I think you've done over 500 Grand Prix yourself. We had the privilege of sharing the commentary box. The privilege was all mine, of course, for 3 years.
Not at all, but
we've got a special task today because we've been asked to talk about our favourite moments together in the commentary box. There were so many of them, but we'll start with you. I think your number one pick was that unforgettable Phillip Island race in 2015, which will live long in the memory.
It will. Trying to commentate it, you didn't have time to breathe, did you?
Who will be king of the island? Mark Marquez in the hairpin on the brakes. And Marquez takes the lead and Lorenzo comes through as well.
Lorenzo leads hard on the brakes. Marquez now looking up the inside of Andrea Iannone. Again, he's in too hot. He momentarily took that second spot. Iannone sweeps straight back through.
They race up through Siberia. They come through 7 and 8. Rossi is very quick here. On to Marquez he comes again. And has Rossi got through?
And I can close my eyes now. I can see them coming down from Lucky Heights into that MG right-hander at the bottom. 5, 6, 7 abreast.
Rossi will fight back hard on the brakes down into turn number 10. He's got the inside line. Iannone nudges Marquez out of the way, aggressive from the two Italians.
Could not be closer. Could not be a better race.
Here comes Marquez to lead the Australian Grand Prix up the inside of Lorenzo. Marquez leads.
This is going to be a four-rider battle. Look at Lorenzo. Oh, Lorenzo is back in front.
Marquez releasing on the brakes. There, we saw Rossi. He was lining it up. We had the perfect shot. Oh, Andrea Iannone, unbelievable from the Italian. Marquez is close to him. He's going to move through on the brakes down into turn 10. Marquez goes for the victory. He's made that move stick. Rossi comes through on Andrea Iannone.
Marquez wins.
What a last lap.
No voice, Nick Harris, Matt Burt.
It was rumoured, I don't know if it was ever proof, that it was more overtaking in that race than the whole of the Formula One car season that year. I don't think I've ever seen a race like it, and it led to enormous recriminations, didn't it?
We couldn't believe what we'd seen. We were absolutely shattered. We certainly earned a couple of beers in Phillip Island that.
Not that we ever drank beer.
Of course we did. Never drink on duty.
Yeah.
Now then, my first pick for one of the great races that me and Nick shared in the commentary box was Mugello 2016. It was the height of the Jorge Lorenzo, Marc Marquez rivalry. It's still the 8th closest finish in Premier Class history. One of the great last lap battles that we saw, Nick. And
yeah,
I've forgotten as well in that race, it was the Grand Prix where the Italian heart sank. Because remember, Valentino Rossi was right at the front and he had the big engine blow up.
That's
which
right.
Left Marc and Lorenzo at the front.
Yeah.
But another classy battle between two of the superstars of Monday MotoGP.
The Italian Grand Prix at Mugello is underway. Side by side into San Donato. And Rossi leads. Can he make it take? Oh, Rossi's running wide. Oh, God, it's blown.
What a day for Yamaha.
That engine has completely blown. Where is it going to be? Closes up as they run across the top end of the circuit. Here he comes. Here he comes up the inside.
Oh, what a move.
What a move by Jorge Lorenzo. Marquez fights back. They're side by side coming up to the final corner. And it's Lorenzo who's going to go through. No, he's not. Marquez. to the line.
Surely Marc Marquez has got this victory in the bag. Marquez, he's been magic in Mugello. What a mesmerising race. Lorenzo tries to find it. Lorenzo's got it on the line. Unbelievable. What a finish here in Mugello.
There's a special race and such a special place as well.
We have to be a little bit patriotic here. We have to be a little bit partisan. Let's not get teary-eyed, but Bruno 2016, steady yourself, we can get emotional later on, but Bruno 2016 was an unforgettable day in the history of British motorsport, not just British riders in MotoGP, because you had the absolute pleasure of calling over the line.
Cal Crutchlow has rewritten the history books. Cal Crutchlow wins here in Brno, the Czech Republic Grand Prix. 35 years ago, Barry Sheen won in Sweden. The last British winner.
It was 35 years that Barry Sheen won at Anderstorp in 1981. I was there and I sat through all these commentary boxes with different people thinking, I'm actually going to be in a box being taken away before we see a British rider winning. Do you remember? It was dampy conditions and we didn't think he had a chance, Cal, to beat Tiberillo. And he started coming through the field. And I remember you looking at me and going, listen, we had no stats.
Here's another modern day MotoGP legend. Look right up.
All right. Really good. See you.
This guy cannot go anywhere in the paddock right now. Can he?
Really
Nick Harris
good,
has been. He's, this guy's being mobbed. He's being mobbed, mate. He's more famous
well
than
done,
you guys.
Mate. Well done on everything.
Great then to see Jack Miller. You cannot go anywhere. You're like the superstar of this race. I think you've signed more autographs and taken more photos than Jack and Agostini here.
So rather embarrassing.
We'll finish then our sequence. Another phenomenal race, and it was kind of the emergence of Andrea Dovizioso and the emergence of Ducati as a title-winning force. The Japanese Grand Prix in the rain at the Twina in Motegi, and that was the first feeling, Nick, that we got that Ducati are out of the doldrums.
Yeah.
They're now going to be title contenders for years to come, as it has been proven.
Round 15 in the MotoGP World Championship. Who will be the rain master here at Motegi?
Wow, Marquez up the inside of Dovizioso at turn three. He picks up the Italian, ruthless as always, by Marc Marquez.
He's not thinking about it. Dovizioso is through on one of the fastest corners at this circuit. Here comes Marquez again. Marquez has got through at turn nine. There's nothing Dovizioso can do. Dovizioso pulls out of the slipstream. He's attacking up the inside of Marquez. Can he make it through? Dovizioso leads in Japan. Marquez comes through at the final corner. Is he going to run wide? Is history repeating itself like in Austria? Dovizioso has done it here in Japan.
It was in Honda's home track. Everything about it wasn't. And Dovizioso was so determined to win that race, wasn't he? And Marquez was so used to winning on the last corner. Not this time. I think it was a real turning point in the Dovizioso-Marquez battle, the Honda-Ducati battle.
Yeah, Andrea Dovizioso, of course, he'll be inducted as a MotoGP legend at our next Grand Prix over in Mugello. This guy needs to be inducted as a MotoGP legend, doesn't he, as well? We're going to have to go very, very shortly, though. But Nick, as we mentioned, 1,000 Grand Prix. You had the pleasure of being here for over half of them. So many great memories. Great to be back here in Le Mans. It must take you back to all those years.
It certainly does, Bertie. My first Grand Prix was 1965, a day trip to the Isle of Man for a TT race, Hayward and Ago. And from then on, it's been my life and a most amazing life you could ever imagine. A life that you're now following as well. And thank you to everybody and everything about it. And being back is difficult. I won't tell you it's not, but seeing so many young people, so many young riders, young people in the media, everything, fantastic. The future of the sport is in brilliant hands.
That's all we've got time for here. It's great to catch up with my old pal. He is a MotoGP legend. I'm not sure he's a MotoGP guru. We'll let him off with that one. As long as I beat him in the MotoGP guru competition this year, I'm not really bothered. Harry, it's a pleasure. Great to catch up with you. We're going to go off down into downtown Le Mans now, maybe have a couple of quiet beers to celebrate the 1,000th Grand Prix here, and we'll toast to the next 1,000 as well.